Somebody that know it, you know. But it's the 11th chapter. We're going to start off at the 11th chapter, and we're going to go into the 12th chapter. We all know the trouble that David got himself into.
Yeah.
He could have went to war, like it should have been his thing to go to war.
Amen.
But you know, when you get, he done fought so many wars, you know.
Yeah.
But this time he didn't want to go. He done got stoked. He done got, you know, how you get weary and tired. So this is the time he got tired. He didn't want to go. He sent Joab to fight the battle.
Yeah.
Now, you know, when you're supposed to be at a certain place, you're supposed to be there.
Amen.
Because you be somewhere else, you get yourself in trouble. Like David got himself in trouble.
Yeah.
You know, we read, you know, the scripture, how that he was thrown up on his balcony or whatever you call it. Looking around, and he sees this woman washing herself.
Yeah.
And his eyes took advantage of him because he watching this woman, and she was very beautiful to look upon.
Yeah.
And so he lust set in. That's what it was, lust sets in. He should have stopped right there.
Bless us, Lord.
That's where he should have stopped right there. He said, he's a man after God's own heart.
Yeah.
He should have stopped right there. But he didn't. He inquired about her.
Yes.
And then he sent for her. And she being a servant of the king, she had to come. I've heard it said, well, she shouldn't have went.
Right, right.
But he's the king.
Yes, sir.
He got life or death in his hand.
Yeah.
She had to go.
Yeah.
So she goes to him. And he lays with her. That's the beginning of sin. And she sends word to him.
Yeah.
That she done conceived. Mm. She's with child. That's another sin. A sin begets sin. Sin is rolling now.
Ball. Yeah.
David trying to get out of this fix. He done got himself in. If he hadn't went to war, he wouldn't have had that to worry about. But he didn't go to war.
Yeah.
He's running around on his balcony. Sees this woman. Now, he got himself in all this trouble. He's trying to find a way out of it. But one lie begets another lie.
Yeah.
So he sends for Uriah, her husband, to come and see him. So he makes a lot of small talk with Uriah. And he tell him, speaking about in different things.
Yeah.
And trying to get him to go down to his house and lay with his wife, trying to put the blame on somebody else.
Yes, sir.
Trying to put the chip, the weight. Well. But God is looking at him all the time. And God, it says, wait a minute.
Wow.
Just a minute.
Yes, that's the time.
Thank you.
It says at the 27th verse of the 11th chapter. The 27th verse of the 11th chapter.
Mm-hmm.
It says, and when the morning was past, David sent and fresh her to his house, and she became his wife, and bare him a son. Mm. But the thing that David had done displeased the Lord.
Yeah, yeah.
Displeased the Lord. The Lord watched, you know, you can't do anything in the sight of God.
That's right.
And God was displeased with what David had did.
Thank you.
Here's David, a man after God's own heart. One thing about David, he knew how to repent.
Yeah.
If he did wrong, he could repent.
Yeah.
But God, so in the 12th chapter, we see the Lord sent Nathan unto David.
Yeah.
And he came unto him and said unto him, there was two men in one city, the one rich and the other poor. The rich man had exceeding many flocks and herds, but the poor man had nothing save one little ee-wee lamb, which he had nourished and brought up, and it grew up together with him and with his children, did eat of his own meat and drank of his own cup, and laid in his bosom, and was unto him as a daughter. And then it speaks about the traveler that came up unto David.
Yeah.
And the traveler came up to David, and there came a traveler unto the rich man. And he said to take of his own flock and of his own herd to dress for the wayfaring man that was come unto him. But he wouldn't take of his own.
Mm-mm.
Even though he got many sheep, many herds, many riches, he wouldn't take of his own. What the poor man had, it says, he took the poor man's lamb and dressed it for the man that was come unto him. And David, anger was greatly kindled. David listening to this prophet talking to him, listening to David, and David anger got all hot headed. He's mad now about such a man could do this to another man.
Yeah.
And then it says, he said to, and he said to Nathan, as the Lord live it, the man that have done this thing shall surely die, and he shall restore the lamb fourfold, because he have done this thing.
Come on.
And because he had no pity.
Yeah.
And Nathan said to David, thou art the man. You are the one.
You
have done this thing. You are the one that have committed these many sins.
Come on.
Against your God. You are the one.
Yeah.
You know, it's bad to sin before God. Oh, it's bad. And then and Nathan said to David, thou art the man. Thus said the Lord God of Israel, I anointed thee king over Israel.
Yeah.
And I delivered thee out of the hand of Saul.
Yeah.
And I gave thee thy master's, houses.
Yeah.
And thy master's wife.
Yeah.
The house of Israel and the house of Judah.
Yes.
And moreover, have given unto thee such and such things.
Yes.
Wherefore hast thou despised the commandments of the Lord to do evil in his sight.
Yes.
You know, when you done sin against God, and God reads you like he done read David here.
Bless us.
I can almost feel, see how David felt.
Yeah.
He done sinned against the God that he loves and cherished. But he could have stopped way up the line.
Yeah.
He didn't have to go that far. But you know, that's the way sin will do you. It'll start you off. Little bitty things. It don't take all of this.
Yeah.
I can do this and God won't notice me.
Yeah.
I don't know what make a person think that God won't see me. David, he's the ruler of all these peoples.
Yeah.
His kingdom. He's the ruler. And he rules them. But he got to give account to God.
Yeah.
He sees everything you do. It's nothing you can do. And God don't see it. That's why people don't, I know that's why I don't sin against God. Yeah. It no matter what it is, God sees it. And if I do anything, I ask God to forgive me. Forgive me, Lord. Sometimes we stray, but that's a dangerous thing to stray.
Yeah.
Because David done got himself in all this trouble. Mm. All this trouble. And yet, I can't read it like I want to read it. Because my eyes ain't the best, but where was I at? And therefore, thou despise the commandments of the Lord to do evil in his sight.
Yeah.
Thou hast killed Uriah the Hittite with the sword.
Yes.
And have taken his wife.
Yeah.
Amen.
To be thy wife.
Yes.
And have slain him with the sword. The chariots of Ammon. Now therefore, the sword shall never depart from thy house. Boy, that's a harsh penalty.
Yeah.
Coming from God.
Amen.
Oh, God. To have that pronounced upon you. And you know the story.
Yeah.
How that his son wanted to take over his kingship. His brother, Absalom's brother.
Yeah.
Absalom's daughter.
Sister.
Absalom's sister.
Yeah.
Ammon was crazy with lust over her.
Yeah.
And down the line, he raped her.
He saw
and all of this vex is coming on David for the sin he committed. I tell you, it's bad. It's sin.
Thank you.
Against God. God, David had it all. Mm. He's winning battles over battles.
Yes, sir.
But then, you know, it's dangerous. It gets slow for us. And I'm concerned.
Amen.
Serving God.
That's true.
You get to a place where it don't take all of this. Oh, I prayed yesterday. I ain't got to pray today. Saints, you got to pray each and every day.
Yes, sir.
Call on God for his help. You need him each and every day.
Yeah.
But when you get spoken and not concerned, you're going to have to pay a penalty for that.
Bless us, Lord.
Because you're going to stop doing the things that you used to do. You used to sit up in the church and get happy and give God away. You don't do that no more. You just shout hallelujah. You don't do that no more.
Hello.
You just got stuck up. And I'm concerned.
Hallelujah.
And that's a dangerous spot to be in. Mm. I tell you, I read a portion of scripture in this Bible. And I tell you, saints, it just blew my mind.
Woo.
And I just want you to turn to it for a minute. I think it's in, I have it here. And I just.
That's it.
I just want to show you this portion of scripture. And have you to read it with me.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. they said, no. Okay, it's in 2 Peter, the 20th verse.
Mm.
I want you to just read that. I want to read what Peter is saying here. The second chapter of Peter and the 20th verse. It says, for after they have escaped it, the pollution of the world,
yeah,
through the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, they are again entangled therein and overcome. The latter end is worse with them than the beginning.
Yes. Good Lord.
The latter end is worse with them than the beginning.
Yes.
For it had been better for them not to have known, the way of righteousness. Then after they have known it, to turn from the holy commandments delivered unto them.
Yeah.
It would be better not to know about the righteousness of God than after you have known it to turn away from it.
Yeah.
They speak about the unpardonable sin.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know what it is, but what I think it is, what I believe it is, when you reject God's Son.
Yes.
When you said no to his salvation, I believe that's the unpardonable sin. Because once you reject Jesus Christ, you ain't got no way.
Yeah,
bless you. Once you reject Jesus Christ, and we see that David, he got out of it because God said he wouldn't die. He wouldn't die. But it's awful. It's bad. To sin against God, and to think that you're gonna get away, you're not gonna get away. I don't know.
Yeah, that's a blessing.
My eyes is getting tired. It's just so much good stuff. It's just so much good stuff in here.
Yeah.
And I just sit on my porch. Sometime and I just read the word of God.
Yeah.
But I ain't gonna worry you long, but I just thank God for this period of time I had to speak tonight. But saints, I tell you, if you're living for God, don't look away. Try to get closer and closer to God. He would each and every day. Yeah. Don't let a day pass by you that you don't tell him thank you. I thank God each and every morning for my health, life, and strength.
Amen.
For the use of my limbs and organs. And organs. I thank God for every breath that I take. I thank God for every step that I take, I thank God. Because he has been so good to me.
Yes.
He has blessed me down through the years.
Yes.
When I was on the south side of Chicago, among all them riffraff and crooks and dope fiends and dope addicts.
Yeah.
And got chased home so many times.
Lord.
But God blessed me that I didn't never get caught, didn't never get hurt, because I could have got killed.
Yes, sir.
So many times. 3 days in a row, I almost lost my life. I wasn't saved. But I got executed on the job. And the nurse told me, said, you hadn't been up there another minute or two, you'd been dead. That was Friday night. Saturday, I'm going back from west side to the south side.
Yeah.
In a car that the threads on the car were smooth as that tape.
Yeah.
And it was raining. Car swirled around 2 or 3 times on the outer drive. And I was all right. Then, Saturday, my buddies were driving the car. I was sitting in the back seat.
Yeah.
He turned off of Michigan onto Indiana. And out of the back seat I went. Getting this running up and down, putting on brakes to keep them hitting me. That was 3 days, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. That's when I made that statement. I'm not gonna live to be 50. Because it looked like death was all around me. But God see me through all of that.
Yeah.
I had many scrapes with death. But God has blessed me. That's why sometimes I just get crazy. You know, I just can't help myself.
Yeah.
Because he's so good. He's good. And if you just give him the praise, you give him the honor and the glory, and you just thank him daily for the things that he do in your life. You know, a lot of people don't be able to get up in the morning.
Amen.
Don't be able to go for it. A lot of people just lay there. But God is so good.
Yes.
And so merciful. So I just thank God for this time I have spent with you tonight. And I'm the only one living in my immediate family.
Amen.
All my sisters.
That's true.
Both sisters. Gone. My mom and dad.
Yes. Yeah.
Bless him.
Mama, thank you, God. My dad died when I was about 2, I guess. And my mom, she was sick all her life. She left him when she was about 54, 55. So you see, I had needed God.
Bless him.
And when I was running around out there in Chicago, I did not know that I had a Savior that loved me.
Praise God. I did not know it.
It's a bad thing when you don't know God, and I did not know Him. But out of His mercy and His kindness and His passion, He had mercy on me. And saved me through all my sisters, all my brothers, my wife,
My stepdaughter
just died in March. My stepdaughter, my wife's daughter. I don't know if she was so grieved by her mother passing away, but she passed away just like her mother did. Her mother passed away in her sleep. And she passed away in her sleep. You know, and I thank God. I thank God for the 42 years that God gave me with my wife. I thank God.
Wow.
I thank God for the way He took her out. Let us just step away. I thank God for that. God is such a good God. And He's such a merciful God.
Amen.
Oh, God, I give you praise, honor, and glory.
Bless him.
All day long.
Praise God.
Oh, you know, if I didn't have God, I'd just rather lay down and die. If I didn't have God as my Savior, I'd rather be dead myself.
Yeah.
But God is just good. Oh, God is just good. Pray my continuous.
Bless the Lord.
Come on, saints, let's give Him a hand clap.